Hello everyone, and welcome to another Strixhaven Draft Challenge. So this is a higher stakes draft event with double the cost to a normal human draft, which is 3000 gems or 20,000 gold. And we are getting rewarded with draft tokens here. It's a double elimination event that goes up until you get 6 wins or 2 losses. And it's a best of 3 format as well. Okay. Eliminate probably the pick here. I do like the necrotic fumes. It's one of the, you know, very nice lessons to have. But eliminate is just a very decent main deck card. Also gets rid of any tokens, which makes it actually better than you would initially think about this card, because you can actually, your opponent casts a big fractal token with 7 mana and you can just use 2 mana to kill it, and that's pretty fantastic. Or something like a elemental summoning and you can kill it with 2 mana. So it's pretty easy pick here for me. A fairly weak pack maybe, the rare is not really good. But the lesson is good though, and the uncommon lesson is good too. And I quite like them. Maybe the study, the pledge mage is okay, and the Quinteros can be good in the correct deck. But eliminate is the kind of the pick that should go to most decks, so it has the highest chance to maybe end up in a deck. And it's also just, you know, a very good card. Brainstorm. Now, well, that's not... It's okay for a cantrip, but that's really all what it is. Unless you have like multiple ways to shuffle your deck, the Brainstorm isn't that much better than an Opt, for example. Opt actually can be better than Brainstorm when the top card is something you want to scry away. Alright, so after Eliminate, am I going to take a Leech Fanatic, because this is fairly weak pack. There's an Ardent Dust Speaker, which is good for 5 mana. But I don't really feel like picking a 5 mana card at pick number 2 when it's not a bomb. I'll take the only black card because this is just a weak pack. There's no reason to deviate from my first pick. And here I have a Humiliate and I have Blood Researcher. Funnily though, also another Dust Speaker. But yeah, both of these are black. Both of these are very good in their respective archetypes. I guess the Leech Fanatic slightly... Well, not only slightly, it actually does synergize with the Blood Researcher quite nicely. But Humiliate is, I think, a slightly better card. There's also Pest Summoning here. I don't see white cards here. I can maybe... Well, there's a different campus, but I'm just figuring out if... Well, because these are close enough to each other that I should just maybe kind of observe... If black-green could be more open. There are some black-green cards, but the Tent the Pest isn't exactly that great. Although the art is very nice. There's a Pest Summoning, there's a Gram Session, which is not just a black-green card. Of course, it's a mono-black and a mono-green card as well. Humiliate is good, but I have a feeling that the black-green might be more open here, based on what I've seen here. But of course, that can change. And now, no green cards whatsoever, no black cards whatsoever. A couple of very nice prismatic cards. Well, there is a black card and there's a green card, but I meant nothing that I would be excited picking here. There is an Eager First here, which is good in the black-white deck. So if I took the Humiliate, it would be easy Eager First here, or maybe even Study Break. I don't like the clever Lumimancer at all with the stats of zero power. It's really... I don't like it. Yeah, these are nice. I think I would take the... I don't know, actually. Both are very good. I don't know which one I would be taking here. But now the question is... Am I going to take the Eager First here, even though I pass the Humiliate here? And still see if black-white is going to be open? I feel like it. I could maybe go to Prismari, but... After picking these cards... Now I'll take the Eager First here and I'll see what happens. The Introduction to Prophecy could be considered as well, but it's not really the strongest of the cards. You know, of the lesson cards. Alright, so I guess my green my guess to go green was actually a bad guess. Yeah, I would be a lot better with Humiliate here now, because I don't know if I can actually get the black green happen. Now there's a Cody which can be in certain decks very good, but I think it's most likely a Prismari deck where this is good, or maybe Quandrix deck, or maybe anything which has access to fractal tokens at least. But because this requires you to cast expensive instant sorceries to get something good, because it's of the requirement of lesser mana value. I think I'll take the Arrogant Poet. It's a fairly weak pack. There's a nice red card and nice lesson, but I guess I'll take the 2-drop and just at least draft black in here. Alright, so there is Owling Shield Mage, and there's a Fractal Summoning. Can I actually be like a mainly black and maybe enough green to support the Fractal Summoning? Because it doesn't seem the white is open. Yeah, I know there's the Shield Mage. My guess is this here mostly because it's a black card, not because it's a white card. The white cards here are pretty non-existent. So the decision is between Fractal Summoning and Owling Shield Mage. I don't necessarily want to have the letter or the Crossing Disappointment. These are the best cards in the pack. So I'll take the Fractal Summoning just in case the black-green can maybe realize in pack 2. If I get enough black-green in pack 2, I could easily just be in that archetype, even though it might mean that I have mostly just black cards and not many green cards, because in pack 3 I don't anticipate green to be open in pack 3. Now there's a big play which is fine, the poet is fine, the disappointment is, well, okay-ish. But I'll take the campus now, it's free mana fixing. What is going on? First of all, this is pick 8, so in my first pick there was a Necrotic Fumes as well. But the actual wondery thing here, what is amazing is that the Professor of Symbology is here in pick 8, a completely, even a first pickable card. I wouldn't be sad to first pick a Professor of Symbology. So it's a very tough choice now. I don't have any learn card, so I'm not going to take the Fumes. It is now between the Professor and the Lass of Malice. I like the Lass of Malice quite a bit, but this is so good. If white turns out to be open, I don't want to miss out on this thing. So I'll take the Professor, even though I realize I might still be black. Green here, but I have only one green card, and of course the green lesson here. But I'll take the Eager first here now. Who knows, maybe Humiliate comes back. That would be incredibly weird if that came back. Now there's a Beaming Defiance, which is fine. Also a Lawhold Campus if I go like black-white and maybe have some red splash, but I don't generally want to splash in this format, so I'll take the Beaming Defiance. And, well, there's a Tempt the Pest, but I'm not even a big fan of this card, even if I played black or green, so I can take the Defender Campus. Why is the Enthusiastic Study here still, though? Okay, well, now I guess I'll take the Campus. Study Break is fine. At least it is a learn card, so if I get some uncolored lessons, that could be fine. So I will cut now the Blood Researcher and the Witherbloom Campus. It didn't seem like a... The green is open. Okay, Fracture is fine. Sideboard card, of course, but this is a best of three event, so it's a very nice for sideboard card. Mind's Desire. Well, I'm past, you know, rare drafting. I have completed the set, so I won't be rare drafting. By the way, this is double mythic pack, which is funny. So there's a Velomacus Lawhold here, of course, which is great, and I have the Lawhold Campus. The only thing that is kind of unexciting about the card is that black-white is such an aggressive archetype usually that playing a 7-drop in there is pretty questionable. Now I have only 3 black cards and only one of them is actually a card I want to have, but I don't know, maybe I should have picked the Enthusiastic Studies in there, because I saw those pretty late. I just never thought that I'm actually moving to, after all these black cards, that I would be moving to red-white. But I think I would take the Guiding Voice otherwise here, but I'll take the Velomacus Lawhold. It is a very strong card and I can splash it. I can easily splash it. Alright, now Killian and Silverquill Silencer. I mean, Killian is just a better card. There's actually no question about it. Yeah, it's just a better stats and better abilities, but this is still a fantastic 2-drop. And especially great later in the game when opponent has used their learn card but hasn't used their lesson yet. You can just name the lesson because it's a card you know it's in their hand. So they can't really use it unless this thing dies or they are willing to lose 3 life and let me draw a card. So it's not a bad card at all. I mean, of course it's not a bad card, but it is a lot better than an average 2-drop, but Killian is just an insane near. It's almost a bomb. Not exactly a bomb, but it's very, very efficient for 2 mana. So it is the pick here over the Silverquill Silencer. And now I see a Gnarled Professor here. I guess the black-green just doesn't happen here. The green wasn't enough open there. That is the case here. I'm going to be black-white here. And I will take the environmental sciences now in case I end up splashing the Velomachus Lawhold. So I'll take it over something like a spiteful squad. And, oh, come on. Hurts me. I mean, I kind of knew this could easily happen because I didn't pass any black and green cards, so I could have taken the rare 5/4 Trampler with less learn, and now I could continue with the Witherbloom Apprentice, and the deck would become quite amazing here. But I guess I made my choice. I will go back base black white. I'll take the Lawhold Campus. I can use it to make the Velomachus splash even easier here. Now there's a Witherbloom Pledge Mage, which I think I would definitely like it more than the Pillar Drop Rescuer and the Study Break. I already have one. I don't necessarily want to play multiple of those. It's a nice 5-drop, especially in this deck, which is interested in going to 7 to get the Velomachus going on. So the splash is now quite easy. All my learn cards, which I have 2 currently, the Professor of Symbology and the Study Break, they do get me the environmental sciences. So that's like a 2 additional ways to get a mountain, and of course I will be playing one basic mountain in the deck plus 2 of these campuses, means that the splash will be super easy. No problem about that. Here I think now there would be a mage duel if I went for the black green route, which I didn't, but I have an Inkling Summoning here, which is going to be a pretty nice card. The Agonizing Remorse is not bad, but I just like to have always access to these on-color summoning cards. Yeah, there. I don't wanna think about how good the black-green deck could have been, because this pack two would have given me so many good green and black cards that it would be great. But I still got the Killian, and I can splash for the Lawhold, Velomachus Lawhold, so maybe it's fine. I'll take the 2-drop here. And here, I'm kind of hoping that I will get just some reward from the pack 3, because pack 3 shouldn't have green as a very open archetype. Well, I mean, a very open color. So hopefully it's not suddenly open from that direction. And I would get some white and black cards. I think the Show of Confidence is fine, but I'll just take the Introduction to Annihilation. Okay, and there's a Guiding Voice, which I definitely want to have here. I'm happy to have that so late. Pest Summoning, sure. Okay, I do like the... Now, Enthusiastic Study is actually a splashable card. Am I gonna take it? How many creatures I have? Only 9, though. I mean, if I'm splashing this Velomachus, I can splash this, and I have a lot of lessons to get to. But I just like the Pest Summoning to have also access to that card. And here, I think Letter of Acceptance is the card I'm gonna play. Easily because of the 7-drop dragon. Not only because it's a fixer, but it can accelerate me into the 7-drop. And with a Bloom Campus, am I gonna splash anything green here? Now there's like a small chance I'm getting a green lesson. The uncommon lesson it's the naturalized variant, right? Well, I'm not gonna pick those other cards. So I don't know. Okay, Study Break now. I can take it, but I will put it to the sideboard. I don't think I want to have 2 of them. But Agonizing Remorse as a pick 14 is quite interesting. Wandering Archaic. Well, that is a good one. This could be a very good black-green deck, indeed. But Wandering Archaic is going to be a great card. This taxing ability is very annoying for the opponent. I know, because I've played this card and made it very difficult for the opponent to play their spells. And of course, I have faced this thing myself, and it's so awkward. Especially if you have like a Fractal Summoning in your hand. You just can't pay the full cost for it. Okay, the Wandering Archaic is the pick here. I'm passing something like a Mage Hunter's Onslaught, but this is the better card. Galazet Prismari. Well, I'm glad I don't have to rare draft anymore. But there is an interesting question here. Because the Expanded Anatomy is a very good card. I would want to have it. But Humiliate is still quite good. Now I do have Agonizing Removal. So this is a card I can easily cut, but I wouldn't cut Humiliate because you get the free counter from this as well. But Expanded Anatomy, I don't have a lot of learn cards, but I have at least three. I really would want to have it, but I think I'll take the Humiliate after all. Tough decision. Okay, well, there is an Expanded Anatomy too. Also there is a Necrotic Fumes. There's a Manatite, but I'm not taking a Manatite in here. So Necrotic Fumes is usually better in black and green, which has no more ways to exile a kind of usually a pest token or something like a, I don't know, well, pest token most of the time. So I think I'll take the Expanded Anatomy over the Necrotic Fumes now. But it's close. Okay, then there's a Reduced Memory, which kind of does the same thing, but doesn't require exiling your own creature, but you give your opponent a 3-2 creature, but it's quite valuable when you exile something that is a lot worse than a 3-2. So I think I'll take it over something like a Expel the Spectre or the Spirit Summoning. I guess I could take a Mage Duel too, and splashing a Mage Duel wouldn't be a problematic thing at all, but I still think it's going to be the Reduce to Memory. There's also a Campus, but I'd really like to have this option in my lesson toolbox. Okay, so Combat Professor, pretty easy pick. Also don't have 4-drop creatures. I don't actually have creatures much at all here, so let's just take it. God's Willing is good, but there's also Umbral Juke, there's a Rise of Extas. Another Environmental Sciences, which is not that important. I think the Rise of Extas fits this deck quite well, although I would like to take the Juke. And the God's Willing is completely playable card too. Feels like this deck could use additional removal, so I'll take the Rise of Extas. I definitely have lessons to grab, that's no problem. Alright, another Fractal here. Dark Ritual is basically 20 gems. I could take that because I don't think I'm going to be having access to Fractal Summoning. I guess I could if I play my. Well, I'm not gonna play the Witherbloom Campus here though. I have a couple of campuses already. Let's take 20 gems because I don't necessarily want to have even the Professor's Warning here. I have too few creatures. Okay, the only. Well, I am splashing for red, so I could take the start from scratch also. That is a nice sideboard lesson to have here. Okay, yeah, I don't think the Stone Rise Spirit is particularly good in this deck, so I'll take this lesson, which I can actually cast with my mana base. Oh, come on. Both of these came back. That is just horrible. This deck is not really good. Black-white wasn't open. I guess I should have gone to green-black after all, but it just didn't seem it was that open in pack one. I don't know. But I guess I'll just take the Assistant here. It's a card I can play at least. And the Pilgrim of the Ages. Actually, that is, I'm very happy about that. This helps me get mana for the dragon that I will be splashing. I still got the Necrotic Fumes. Okay. Definitely my lesson toolbox is good. And I think rather than a Campus Guide, I will actually play the Cogwork Archivist. This deck is not really an aggressive black-white deck. It's more like a very late game focused with my cards, but I don't know. It doesn't seem like a very good deck, to be honest. Sure, maybe I'll take another one of those. Although, I don't know. I have enough ways to get the red mana anyway, and I have only one 8 drop here. As the red card, plus the start from scratch, of course. Well, the deck is what it is. I guess I can put the Study Break there too. Is there any other card I might consider playing in there? Don't think so. Don't think so at all. So yeah, I don't expect to get a very high amount of wins with this deck. But what is the game plan? I have a couple of 5-drops, 6-drop and a 7-drop, Rise of Extus. But I do have a Letter of Acceptance and Environmental Sciences, so I can get mana for myself. I have some early game and then not much after that. My curve is so weird. So weird. So I'm actually having only 24 cards here as well. So what does this mean? Well, it means I'm gonna cut only one card, because with the letter and the environmental sciences, I don't feel like playing 18 lands. Man, I would have gotten so good black-green deck here. But it's too late now. So I guess I can play just a few early drops here, and then try to buy time to get to my heavy hitters here. I mean, of course, Velomakus can just win the game. Wandering Archaic with the Blue Pledge Mage are big things. Archivist is fine. Rise of Extus gives me card advantage. And also I have this thing to get me land. So the, you know, these more expensive cards, I have some ways to get lands. Because of course this deck, if it gets stuck at four lands, I could draw one of these expensive cards and that would be bad. But I don't think I'm gonna get stuck to four lands that often. But what is the card here? I think I might even play the main deck Defender Campus just to have some removal. I have a very low amount of removal, and another Study Break is probably what I'm gonna cut here. Let's see the lesson toolbox. That is quite impressive actually. But still, the most useful lessons I have here are the Inkling and Summoning. I think usually the environmental sciences is interesting, and Expanded Anatomy can be good. But these other ones can be good too. How many learn cards there are now that I cut the other Study Break? Well, that's four. I guess the assistant can get one of those back though. Not the Symbology Professor, but maybe these two. So I have these discard spells. I have early plays, ways to protect my stuff. Yeah, I don't know, this is a weird deck. I haven't drafted anything like this. I don't think it's a good one, but I also don't think... Well, I think I should have gone... somehow guessed that I should stay black-green, and I would have gotten a lot of good black-green cards from also from the third pack as well. But it really was the fault of the Professor of Symbology, which was... It was a pick 8 in pack 1. I was feeling that, okay, that means white must be open, right? It's such a good 2-drop. But in the end, it wasn't open. And then I got the Killian in the pack 2 there. But I think this is the deck. That's a very weird deck. But let's see how it goes. This is best of 3 events, so I can sideboard into... Well, I don't know if I can even sideboard into much different stuff, but... let's see how it goes. So a campus. And I suppose... With the environmental sciences, I could put a mountain in this deck, but I also could not, because I have the letter of acceptance and triple Lawhold Campus. I'm quite likely to get some of them before I get the Velomakus mana here, but I guess I might just still do it. Because if I add now a mountain in here, let's put the dragon, the one with the dragon shadow, just kind of showing the opponent what they are expecting to see. So now I have three white sources here. So let's put three swamps here to kind of balance that. So now I will add five and five swamps and plains. That means I will have a 8 and 8 mana base for the swamps and plains, plus of course the environmental sciences to get something. Although I can't keep hands without Plains, I don't think, because my learn cards, the early learn cards are white. So I can't get the environmental sciences without having access to white mana. So that could be a reason to run an additional white source. Or then I just cut, I'm sorry, I don't cut anything, or I just mulligan into a white source always. But then again, there's a letter of acceptance. That is a one additional source for all the colors. So maybe, yeah, that's like 9 and 9, given that I have the letter of acceptance here. It can slow me down quite a bit, but I guess that has to be it. Yep, let's do it. So five more of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 5 of planes. And this is it. Let's see if I can get some wins. So it's a double elimination event. It's over after 2 match losses. Well, I have a game plan, which involves getting to Velomaku's Lawhold mana, which I can do. Letter of Acceptance and the Guiding Voice getting me Environmental Sciences helps me quite a bit. And I have early game here to maybe deal with their aggression, which they seem to be having here. So next turn I can play the other Eager First Year and the Guiding Voice. I can do that, but I can also do a Letter of Acceptance into Guiding Voice, which is better. If they're tapped out. If they're not tapped out, that's too risky. Okay, I don't actually care about racing here, so I'll do this. Well, that's fine. They just used 2 mana to kill this thing, and they didn't even get to use mana for that. Oh, Pilgrim. Well, that I want to have now instead. This ensures me a land drop for the next turn. Okay, so I can actually... It's a good game plan with the Velomaku's now. Hopefully they get to use all the removal before the Velomaku's comes up. Essence Infusion there. Well, that guy's gonna eat a... defend the campus. Yeah, no blocks. You can take your life and... let's see. I could take another 4 point from there, but... And I could play the Guiding version here, but... let's just, let's do this just in case. Now that they are tapped out. I won't be attacking. They can start, doing 1 damage a turn here. Don't care about that. No, they are just leaving it as a blocker. My only mountain was drawn here too. Alright, so they are having mana up here. So I'm not gonna go for the Guiding Voice yet. I don't even know what I want to have with it. I don't need the mana anymore. I guess I didn't even need it because I have the Letter of Acceptance too. But do you know what this means? I have a turn 6 Velomaku's now. Because I got the acceleration and I have the land here too. It would be nice to play the Guiding Voice here, but not against 4 mana here. And 3 cards too. So okay, they get to draw cards. And... Oh boy. Do I want to play the Velomaku's? Especially if they tap out, then yes. But we'll see. I want to... Well, I guess this is an attack trigger, so... They would have to have something very specific to... To prevent this from attacking. Now they can have a study break and then they can have like a Mage Hunter's onslaught after that. But I'm gonna go for it. Don't have a study break, please. Or if you have it, don't have a removal after that. Okay, I get to attack. And I guess I will attack with all. And I will have a... Ooh, wandering. No, this is an instant of sorcery. Yeah, I'm not going to cast the Explore the Wastelands. That's not gonna happen. So I guess Humiliate, because they have 3 cards. Let's take a Humiliate. Okay, they get to draw cards, but I get to Humiliate something away. So they would have to have 2 removals for the Velomaku's. Okay, why would they do that? Do they have 3 lands in their hand? Yes, they do. Alright, well then I'm not worried. So no discard, but I get a counter on a, I guess the Eager first here. So they need to draw removal for the Velomachus, otherwise. Yeah, they're gonna lose otherwise. Okay, that is barely relevant. Yeah, they are pretty much done now. So Guiding Voice getting me an expanded anatomy, yep. They don't want to see anymore. They could have gotten more information from my deck, which would have been relevant. I would have cast something for free here. So that was game one. This is a best of three event, so I need to win another game too. So they have an Essence Infusion. Well, I'm happy I have my defend the campus here. Fracture. Nope. No targets that I see here. My deck really doesn't have a lot of stuff to side, but I guess I could have like another study break if something here was very bad. But I don't think anything in here is very bad, so let's just keep the same deck. I don't expect to be sideboarding more in this event. I mean, not expecting to be sideboarding a lot in this event, because my sideboard is very, very, you know, doesn't have really options. So that's a Guiding Voice, which can get me the black mana. Hopefully the opponent will tap out so I can have a safe casting for this. They did mulligan to 6 though. I also have the red mana here, so I don't have to worry about using the environmental sciences for that. Now that is of course a very, very good card. Yeah, maybe they enhance it with the +2, +2, the essence infusion. What's that? Okay, they have very good stuff here going on now. That has many, can't block it, but I can now. Can do now what exactly? Letter of Acceptance into Guiding Voice. That's going to get me, I think. I guess I could take the reduced memory and get rid of the Inkling, Killian here. I could take just a, you know, environmental sciences. I do need double black for this thing. I have only one black here available. But then again, I can cast most of the stuff. With Humiliate, I would be actually a little bit wiser. It's a tough one. It is a tough one. I could just take like a, you know, the Inkling here as well. I could take the Pests, because they can double block the Killian, but I need two. No, I can't do that, it's a double caster, can't have the mana for that. Well, that's a tough one, that really is. I guess the Inkling is still something quite safe. Or maybe I'll just take the environmental science, make sure I get the... Yeah, make sure I get the double black happening here. I actually won't be attacking here because I'll just block the apprentice. Even they can have the, you know, Magecraft trigger for it, but I just don't want to take any more damage than is necessary. So let's block the apprentice here. I'm only trying to survive here. Yep, that's okay. Humiliate doesn't have a creature to put the counter on currently, so maybe I will play the Combat Professor here. Might have to do that. Okay, they don't have any triggers for that thing anymore. That is very good news for me. Now this is also quite okay. I can get the planes and then I can cast the environmental sciences. I think I do that rather than go for the Humiliate quite yet. I think. That is better for my mana. I can then also play the Archivist here. I have the double block for the Killian available, but I think I want to humiliate first, see what I'm facing here, and then maybe even have to defend the campus up. Flunk. Oh, it's only -2/-2, so they couldn't kill the combat professor. I'm pretty happy about that. And they chose to do that instead of pumping the apprentice there. Interesting, they could have forced more damage through, because, oh, I mean, I'm assuming they are willing to trade the thing here. Now that is going to be good too, but I think this is the turn when I'm going to humiliate. Although, nah. But if they have another Beaming Defiance, that would be bad. Although, wouldn't they just attack in that case? Yes, they would. The mana efficiency is just best with the Rise of Extus, and I do want to get rid of the Killian no matter what. Okay, let's try this. So this gets exiled, and I will exile the flank as well. I would be very surprised if they have a... Okay, they have more of that stuff. Well, that still gets killed. But I would have been very surprised if they had a... If they had their Beaming Defiance. Right, so they have only the 2-2 there. I can't block the 2-2. I have ground guys here. But am I going to take here... Inkling? I guess it's the Inkling. Let's take a Flyer. Then I can start playing stuff here. I guess if I draw a swamp, I can go Pledge Mage into Humiliate. But yeah, they have some nice cards. Double Flank here, for example. Oh, I did draw the swamp. Well, let's do it then. That leaves me white and Eleterra, so I can cast the Humiliate also. Hopefully they don't have like a Defend the Campus. Well, okay, why ever would you do that? Well, I guess, I don't know. Doesn't matter really. I get to choose their worst card. Okay, they draw more cards, but I mean, I still get to choose the worst card out of their hand here. That's a main deck reduced to memory, isn't it? So they can exile this thing to give me a 3-2. Mage Hunter is actually not going to be that great. It is slightly annoying, but then again, whenever I lose a life, I will be gain life from this thing. I will be gaining life from that thing. So maybe the reduce the memory is the way to go here. I can play the Cogwork Archivist. But I could see taking away the Mage Hunter, and then they will just downgrade this great creature slightly. Okay, fine. Let's do it. I don't want to lose life. Because I still have stuff here and I can, you know, draw like the Bellmacus business like that. That is actually going to be dealt with by the Defend the Campus. Can I win a game without drawing the dragon? It seems to be the case. And that was the match. So this pretty weird deck actually won its first match. So that means I get at least one draft token. So the event cost 3000 gems or 20,000 gold. So equal to 2 drafts. So one draft token gives me like half the entropy back. So getting two wins gives me only just one draft token and three packs, which are pretty useless to me because I have completed the Strixhaven set. But the third win is the sweet spot. Getting back two draft tokens means that the event didn't cost me anything because I will of course be drafting anyway. So the token is worth 1500 gems to me, no matter what. Yep, well, I got all the colors here, so even a 2-drop, Agonizing Remorse, Study Break can get me something. Swamp. Okay, so am I going to... Okay, this gets me something too. I guess we just trade here, why not? Let's play the mountain here. They could have the discard spell, and I will take an Inkling summoning. That is a bit annoying. Although black-white doesn't have as much life gain as black-green has, but it is annoying nevertheless. Well, that is just going to trade with the professor here. Sure, gonna lose to this drudge in here. I wanna make them use their life gain effects because I don't want the drudge to come back that easily. So, do I want to have a random card or another Inkling flyer here? The study break can get me the red thing that pings for one damage here. I think I can just rather maybe draw the Inkling summoning here. Yeah, sure. So next turn I can have an Inkling and an Agonizing Remorse. Although this will just trade with the flyer of mine. Oh. What's with these opponents playing the Essence Infusion here? Yeah, that's a pretty risky card to play. I mean, I could have stuff to deal with it, and I do. I can exile this with the... I do have the Introduction to Annihilation here, right? I do. So I'm only going to Study Break there and... I guess I'll trade with that thing now, because I won't be getting the ping thing here. Yeah, let's do this. Play the Inkling Summoning, play the Study Break, and... Okay, that's completely fine. I guess I could Agonizing Remorse here too. Just in case if they have something very annoying in there. Although I do want to clock them as well. Okay, I will want to clock them. This leaves me mana enough to Study Break, yes it does. I guess the Agonizing Remorse will still find something. And if I draw a land, I can go for the, you know, the Introduction to Annihilation and Agonizing Remorse. Oh, I could check the Register Memory too. I don't have to give them a card. Yeah, the 3-2 is actually a lot less, and also it costs, I mean, yeah, that also allows me to actually cast the Agonizing Remorse. So yeah, Reduced to Memory, non-land permanent, which is going to be the drudge. And if they have something like a Beaming Defiance, oh, that was annoying. Okay, Remorse them. Wow, they got a... Well, let's get rid of the statement here, but... Yeah, the Owling Shield Mage, that was annoying. That was really annoying. I was thinking about raising them with my Air Force here. I can no longer do that. I can't even block these things because they have the saving loaded, but there was no way I'm gonna... Okay, look at their hand. They had two very relevant spells. I mean, I really wished I could have just... Man. If I block a flyer here, they're gonna get a +1/+1 counter and somewhere. I have to take here 5 damage and hope to draw something. That's my only chance, because... If I double block the shield mage, I lose all my... They will have 5 power of flyers still here. I can block this thing, but they can... Oh man, that was horrible. They had the closing statement and the lore rate, which... And this lore rate is super relevant right now here. Oh boy, oh boy. If I block this 2-1, they get a counter somewhere here. They give it the counter to the low rate for sure. Then I can't even trade with the low rate anymore. Okay, I will take the 5, but I think I have lost the game now. That was just too bad that they had all that stuff. Killian is actually not that great here, but I guess it can give me time to... I have a scry here. I can still maybe draw the Velomachus, but now they had to draw land here, but because I'm not gonna survive that well here otherwise. So, Because I still need to draw something like a Velomachus, I guess I'm going to do this. And I guess I'm gonna do this. Let's see what happens. I'm at 5 and they have a free counter somewhere. Don't be a spell. Just pass the turn. Eliminate can get rid of the laureate. I guess I'll draw it then. And then I will have another scry. And I have one turn to find an answer for this thing. And actually, I could have considered the jump block, because now the Rise of Extus won't be an out because of the ward cost in there. But I think the Velomachus is my only way to deal with this situation. I can still draw a combat professor, or they can have stuff. So, dragon. Dragon is needed. Come on, dragon. That's not a dragon. I know I can play this and jump block them both, but at that point even the dragon won't be that good. But I guess it's still an out because it can find me something that... Yeah, it can find me a spell that gets rid of the pledge mates. Yeah, that's my out. I will draw a Velomachus. And the Velomachus will find me a Rise of Extus, and they don't have a spell here. So I need Rise of Extus from the Velomachus, but first I need the Velomachus. That's not gonna help. Okay. Fracture, not having a target. Study break number 2. Instead of what? I guess the defender campus. Well, it can kill the... Okay, it can kill stuff they are gonna boost with the essence infusion. It can kill the pledge mates. Yeah, I will play it. Plus, it has the pump effect too. If they don't have a target for the removal spell, I can maybe have a very expensive combat trick in there. Alright, so I don't think any of these cards is particularly useless, so I will just submit this deck and hopefully they don't get as good draw as they did in this game. But I'm pretty sure their deck is just better than mine, so they probably deserve the win from this match based on the deck qualities. But I have now all the mana here because I can get the environmental sciences. This is actually a quite nice hand. I can go with Professor of Symbology, get the environmental sciences into swamp, and I can, you know, play my hand and hopefully... Oh, game plan is now... Game plan is pretty clear now. Did they have a mana up? Did they have a one white mana spell here? That could be like a Defiant Strike, yeah. I think. Letter of Acceptance. I'm happy about drawing it because I have the Velomakus here. But they have a... like the Shadewing Lord. I'm not going to eliminate the Vika first here. I'm just thinking about that. Why would I pump the Professor here with the Guiding Voice? Because the situation is so that it will still trade with the Ike first here. So I guess I'll just have the Letter of Acceptance and don't do anything. Not sure if that is very smart, but it feels like a waste of the counter here. That should be exiled combat professor. Huh. So, could play the sciences, but then I have only 3 mana. Would I eliminate it? It's a possibility. But it's also a possibility that I just play this thing and take the 4 damage once. Because I won't be able to raise this very well, so I guess I'll just have to eliminate it and hope they don't have immediate life gain. Life gain up. I kind of wish they would have played the thing they have there. You know, the one that gives plus one counters. And lifelink. Because then I could have still eliminated it. My Guiding Voice can get me removal for that stuff. But... what do I do in here? I can play the Environmental Sciences and the Guiding Voice. And still have mana up for the eliminate. So let's do that exact thing. And I could take like a even an expanded anatomy, but I don't think that's the correct choice in here. I could take the start from scratch to just deal with the Arrogant Poet if I need to deal with it. And of course I can take the reduced to memory, but that's not gonna be so great. Inkling, not that bad either, but... I just need to survive until I can cast this Velomakus here. I guess I'll take the start from scratch because that can be used to deal with the Poet in there. I will take another... I don't know, I might kill the Trudge here, but let's see what they do. Attack with all. Let's see what they do when I do this block. Defiant Strike. Okay, they won't even get to draw a card, unless they have also a Defiant Strike in here. So exactly that. Oh man, this is... I'm disgusted. I had a chance, but no, they had the perfect sister. But I do got my dragon on the next turn now with this land draw. So there is that. And I think... oh man, I hate them having this Beaming Defiance. That was... I actually would have been in a very good shape if I was just able to counter the Defiant Strike here. Oh man, this is gonna be so hard. I'm gonna, if I play the assistant, I can return the eliminate, which is probably what I need to do here. Next turn I will no matter what play the dragon here. Now I know I can just kill this and take 6 or maybe more if they have a triggers for this thing. But this is just more mana efficient. Well, it's not a lot, only 1. I need to do something, by the way, so let's just take the eliminate. Seems like the best I will trade with the Ike first roll. Well, let's say try to trade with it. Also, I can just block the trots. Maybe they don't have a life gain coming up. Okay, let's save most life here now. Because if they don't have removal for the Velomakos, I will of course win here. Okay, that's not bad. I have an answer for that. Let's see what I draw now. This is super important. I'm not draw, but defend the campus. Doesn't kill anyone, and this is only the explore the wastelands. Now I might still do it because it gains both of us 3 life, and I'm more interested in that. So it says each player puts the cards there. Top 5 cards, a land, and an instant of sorcery. But I don't want to let them dig into an answer. Yeah, I'll just pump this thing. Now, because yeah, they would be able to dig for an answer on this thing. So hopefully they don't have one. If they do, that's game over. There's one card I don't know about. It's a spiteful squad. Okay, they can't attack unless they're willing to sacrifice their stuff. I have a 2-turn clock here now. Wow, they actually go for it. That's very interesting. I don't think that's a winning gameplay. Now, is it? I go to 6, but I can kill the poet and I can kill the eager first here. I mean, the shield mage was an additional block for them. Okay, let's attack first. See what I draw. Well, not with what I reveal here. Beaming Defiance doesn't actually do a lot. Agonizing Remorse could remove the trudge, but it's really not relevant here. So I guess I'll just do this in case they find some kind of a... you know, life gain. I will still have a lethals up here. So next. And I will definitely just deal 8 damage to this guy, and I have the eliminate up here now. Okay, Velomakos Lord. It can win games. Might be the only thing here. Well, no, I did win the match 1 second game. I did win without the dragon, so maybe it's not that required. Right. How many hits I have for it, by the way? I have here total of 8 instants and sorceries. So this looks at the top 7 cards, so it's quite likely to find. I have like every 5th card in my deck on average is an instant or sorcery. So this is going to hit fairly often. So I just have so few ways to... I mean, do I want to have a study break here? But what would I cut if I took a study break there? I don't think there's much to cut. I do want to have the Agonizing Remorse. It's nice against their tricks. I can get rid of the tricks. Yeah, let's just use the same deck. Well, I have 2 cards I can cast, but like I said, all my learn cards that can get me more colors are white. So I would have to draw one of the 8 white-producing lands or the Letter of Acceptance. Is Arrogant Poet into Agonizing Remorse going to be enough? This would be a good hand if one of those lands produced white mana. I can trade with their early drops. But I guess without the white mana, it has to be a mulligan, yeah. Okay, this is slightly better. I return. I do have a double. Well, I have double casters for both, but I guess I can find. I don't actually know. Maybe I'll just lose some planes here. Well, at least I drew the second white already. Okay, look at this deck. Look at this hand. Now, they don't have a drop for the next turn. Can I kill this? If I study break into removal, yes, I can. These park I will just leave there. They can't cast the shield mage anytime soon, so it is either of these two, but the Extus Overlord is just pretty nasty. I guess I'll have to take it. And I have to accept the fact that they can just kill something with the closing statement while groping one of their other guys. Oh, they even drew a spell they can cast. That hurt me a lot. Yeah, that hunt for specimens there, that was really bad. I guess I should have maybe study break here. Well, I can take one more. Let's learn what they do here. And they drew the land too. Yeah, it's just not gonna happen now. Their draw was way too good. Because I just literally don't have ways to... I mean, I can try to get rid of this. I can have a sequence of draws that allows me to win, so I'm not gonna concede, but this was just... I mean, I mulliganed here and all that. They have a perfect draw, and they even got the turn... You know, the top deck testing that they didn't even have to miss any play. And they literally drew the lands for the 5 dropper in time too, so... Yeah. I need way more stuff than I can. Because they have still the closing statement here too. So, whatever creature I play. I guess I have a Dimming Defiance if it's a cheap creature. But... this is really bad. I guess I have to take the Inkling. I can at least cast the Inkling, and if they try to remove it, I have the Beaming Defiance. The sad thing is that they have the Bowling Shield Mage, which I can't even block. And that's gonna cost a ton of life if I kill this thing. This is an instant, so I can't go for the Defiance here. Yeah, this Rise of Extus isn't gonna be enough. Pilgrim, though, can block the Leech Fanatic. Now, if I... No, they can... Destroy target creature or planeswalker you don't control. So they can't cast this if I don't have a creature. So I could, in theory, kill this, exile this thing. And then they can't cast the closing statement to give the counter to give, you know, the lethal damage. Because then that would mean that I would have to have a creature. So they can't. So I would be going to 1, because I would be going to 4 here. But I'm going to go the very low life total no matter what. I am doing it. Did they draw the Beaming Defiance? they should really... Let me pay the... That doesn't work, it's an exile effect. That does nothing. But even they still should have, of course, you know... wait until I pay the 3 life. But this doesn't literally do anything. When it dies. It's not gonna die, it's gonna get exiled. So they actually had to win there, because they could have used this make your mark here. Okay, what I need to do here, I need the environmental sciences, which is quite sad. Because I need the life. Need the life here. But, I mean, can I? Because I will go to 1 life. The Pilgrim of the Ages won't be enough. I guess I just have to be lucky and... No, I take the Pest Summoning. I was stupid. Yeah. That was obvious. I mean, I think for that for way too long. Okay. So there's a chance. There is a actual chance here. So Pilgrim... And pests would not leave me Beaming Defiance up. Do I even need it, though? They can't cast this. They can kill one of them. and my pests gain me life. I guess I can do pests and the leech fanatic and then have the beaming defiance up. Okay, that seems a lot better. But man, if I can win this game, that would be so insane. But I'm very, very far away from winning, to be honest. Very far away from winning. So they're gonna kill the fanatic. And I'm gonna use a beaming defiance there. Save it from the death. Now they, that will still have a counter, but I have blocks here. I have blocks in here, unless they drew. Okay, that was just a land. Wow, wow, and wow. So I'm gonna... Well, there's a chance for me now. Wow. I'm at 3 life now. Uh-huh. This is funny. This is so funny. I think I might even scry, but no, I will just try to find... try to start attacking here. Maybe they hit a pocket of lands and I'm very lucky. Who knows? Defend the campus. Not bad. Okay, only 27 life to work. Oh man. Then they get the scry land now too, so they get to improve their draws now. Quite a bit. Okay, that's not bad. They will exile it though. But I guess yeah. Okay. Decline this. So because they will exile it, I don't wanna do this. Because I want to scry instead. If I had mana to play this and scry, and I don't think the explore the wasteland is important now. I might be playing it at some point if I need a 3 life, but so far I will just keep scrying here. And if I draw my Velomachus, then I will of course play the Wandering Archhike. Before that. Well, that can actually get me back for like a Rise of Extas. I'll keep that on top. They can exile it, but that doesn't matter at all. No scrying for me, but I wouldn't want to even scry because I know what's gonna be on top of my deck here. And it's going to be Rise of Extas, right? I have plenty of lessons to learn here. So this is gonna exile whatever creature they're gonna play. Scry on top or... Okay, on bottom. Okay. Let's see if they want to use this park right away. Because if they are doing that, I can just play my Wandering Archhike in that case. Upkeep Scry. They still have 4 mana left. And bottom that thing too. Okay. So they didn't want to despark this quite yet. But I have a 6 power here. It's quite a bit. Quite a bit. Let's see if they wanna now get rid of the assistant. They know that I know they have it, so yeah, but they... Maybe they just are gonna do it just because... Well, they are playing around me having Velomachus, which makes sense, of course. Well, I'm not gonna cast anything because they do have the despark mana up here. They didn't scry on upkeep now. Okay, that is... Okay, that is interesting. I guess I will... Well, let's scry first. Now, I can't cast this targeting the shield mage because it costs me 3 life, which I don't have here. I can attack with the 2-1, these ground guys, and use the defensive campus. I can't attack with the Biblioplex assistant for obvious reasons. What I can do, I can play Explore the Wastelands, and then I have mana to kill the shield mage. That would be sad. I think I still have to do it though. I have the mana for it. I do have 9 mana here. But I have to do it first. If they find a Beaming Defiance, that will be so bad. guess I'll just try my luck here with the Arrogant Poet, and they're not gonna block here, but maybe for some weird reason they are never gonna block here. Oh man, they did block. Oh yeah, this is so good. I mean, this is amazing. The reason I couldn't attack with the assistant is, of course, they don't block. I don't have a jump blocker. And if they block the assistant, this trick doesn't work because they can exile the assistant. But that was, let's just say, that was amazing that they chose to block there. I never thought that would happen. And I can't even scry now. So they are again in the same situation. They need to, I mean, find something that deals with my stuff here. Okay, and now they know I have an answer for that. But they have to still, of course, play it. Unless they have like a removal spell. Okay, I can play both these and... Yeah, sure. By the way, I'm running out of time here. Pretty funny. Opponent has 22 minutes left. I have 9 minutes. What the... They conceded. Wow, I won this match. I was at 1 life. Oh man. I didn't even need the dragon. I wasted a lot of time here. Look at this. Opponent had... They had spent only 7.5 minutes in the entire match. I had spent 21 minutes. I know I'm recording, I'm explaining my thought process, so it's gonna slow you down always. But that was like a... I mean, I apologize to the opponent because that was miserable for them to... I mean, wait so for my decisions for so many... For so long, but... I guess the time system is there to allow us to... make our decisions. Okay, so again, swamps and one card I can cast. It's a mulligan. Because if I had planes and black cards, at least my white couple of white cards could give me the lesson, you know, the ability to find the environmental sciences. I'm gonna mulligan this. And this is a lot better. And a cogwork archivist. Well, no, actually the study break could be... Yeah. This is not very good when you only are going to get some lesson here. So maybe I'll lose it. The tap ability isn't that amazing. Okay, I have 5 and 6 drops here. Now I only need to draw a creature so I can get my... Well, there is the creature. Do I want to eliminate that thing? No, I will see that 3-drop. It could be a lot worse than this thing. But if they are offering a trade, it's a kind of a tough spot for me. Because I don't wanna... I need my... I'm not gonna block here. I need to cast the Guiding Voice. Okay, they get a tutor in there of demonic kind. Would they have a Lash of Malice there? But I need the environmental sciences, that's what I was gonna say. And now there's that thing. Well, okay then. So they tutored up something I don't know about. Wow. I guess so for mana efficiency's sake I will do this, but I would rather have this to be a surprise. Anyway, environmental sciences is the obvious pick here, because I have 5 and 6 drops waiting to be played. I do have the eliminate they don't know about, but they probably have just a... Well, that was a removal spell on my... basically a 2-drop. It had the Guiding Voice improvement, but it got me the land anyway. Okay, this is good, I can kill this thing. I will get... I need only... I have 1 red mana, I never need more than that. I have 2 white, 2 black here. I guess I have a double caster black here, so let's take the swamp here. And I guess I'm gonna take the 2 here still, because they might play some 3-drop here that is going to be more threatening than that thing in there. Okay. That was not the case. Okay, that's not bad. 5-drop and 6-drops are happening, and am I going to want to trade here? Now the thing is that if they have removal for the pledge, but I'm not going to block here anyway. So if they kill the pledge mates, I will not try to trade here. I mean block here. I could only jump here or trade with the 1-1 token, which I don't want to do. So I guess I'm going to pay 2 to make us both lose life. If they kill the pledge mates, I still have... Well, I don't have the Cogwork Archivist anymore. I need to draw now something good. Hopefully they don't also have removal. Okay, well that is... Agonizing Remorse. Well, I mean, it was better that they had an Agonizing Remorse that removed 6 drop from my hand than that if they had like a removal for the Witherbloom pledge mates. Now I'm just not sure if I can attack here anymore. I guess I will, because they will be attacking too. Let's do this. I have the Scry here up. Maybe I'll find my dragon. I can cast it on the next turn. Oh, don't have removal for the pledge mates. No. This is so horrible. I'll be at 5 now. Yuck. Okay, well, Omakus, let's do it. You have brought me victory in earlier games too. Hey, that's not working. That's not gonna work. I have to chump block the professor here now. Otherwise, I will just lose right away. So I have to get pretty lucky in here. That's... The opponent even didn't like, give me that option. So they have a double Rise of Extus. That is something I can use my discard card for. Agonizing Remorse and the Humiliate will be extremely useful there. And again, no target for Fracture. So I don't need more study breaks. That's the deck really. I don't even know against what kind of deck would I want to have a study break. Don't know. At least I can keep a 7 lander. No, not a 7 lander. That would be a bad hand. 7 card hand. So, Fanatic. Letter. Yeah, I can actually play my entire hand. So no matter what I draw, I can play all the spells, all 4 spells in this hand. And opponent mulligans. 2-5. I can win a game in this match, but of course I would need to win another game too. Let's try with the lifelinker. Maybe they don't have a blocker when they mulligan to 5. Nothing instant speed here, so let's just attack. Play the pilgrim. And then next turn I can go... I have a letter of acceptance into a 2-drop. I don't have more than 5 planes in the deck, by the way. I have 3 already here. Because 3 of my white-producing lands are campuses, right? I think I have 3 of them. Lawhold campuses, don't I? I'm pretty sure. Okay, the opponent is thinking about some play here now, for some reason. I guess they might have a Lash of Malice. They took the 2 damage here, just to see if my 3 drop is more important thing to kill. But, well... So I will just say to check it out. So 2 planes left and Lawhold Campus. Lawhold Campus and Lawhold Campus, yep. Okay, no, nothing that they could use there. A 3 drop. Trudge. Oh, that would have been nice to exile. But oh well. Let's race here. I'm actually winning this race, of course, so... I'm still going to just take the Eager first tier here, rather than the Agonizing Remorse. And that's gonna halt the attacks. Except I can attack with the Eager first tier here. Let's exile something from there. another drudge. Wow. Infuse with vitality. Well, I'm gonna take the drudge away, of course. I don't wanna, because this gets exiled. It's not coming back. And then I will have the Biblioplex assistant, which I'm going to use. Well, no, first I'm going to just attack here. Because it's gonna block as a, only as a 2-2, so that's not really that useful. But assistant can get me the remorse back. So I can get rid of that infuse with vitality. Now I could have just, you know, played this as a, you know, something that... there's no point blocking here much. They can just gain life and return this to their hand. I'll take the 4 here. But I could have just chosen not to put this on top of my deck. But I think I want to do this now. Force them to use the infuse here. They will use it now, so I can't attack with the Eager first year. Oh, they actually... Well, I'm gonna get rid of the Rise of Extus for sure. But now that they have the infuse in there, I am not going to attack with the Eager first year. That really doesn't make any sense. So I will do this. And that also means I will now be blocking the Trudge, because my Pilgrim of the Ages is a card I can just, you know, be bringing back. It is very expensive, but it's still something I can do. I have now 5 mana, sadly, so I can't bring it back quite yet. Emergent sequence. I'm not gonna draw that card with this thing because it's my only red source currently. Okay, the Archivist is good. So I can go for the double block here. If I block with the Cogwork Archivist. But no. I guess they have something. Because the problem is, if I double block, they will still just get it back. And they will trigger the end of the battlefield ability. So I'll take the 4 here now. Okay, so now I will make them use the infuse here. Oh, by the way, with the Cogwork Archivist, I can get rid of the Brackish Struts. Very important here. But they can't activate this until they have gained life. And this has to tap. I will gain 2 life though myself too. And I will finally get rid of the infuse with vitality. So I'm going to attack. Because I can play the Leech Fanatic to block any. Yeah, okay, let's do this. It's fine. I don't think I should have attacked with the assistant. I don't know why I did. That was just me messing up there. That was me messing up. So I will now let this happen, and I guess they're gonna play the... No, they're not gonna even play the Infuse with Vitality. Oh, they are. Just cry here instead. Okay. Yeah, but I completely missed the attack with this thing. That was so stupid. That was literally me miss. You know, I was planning to attack with the flyer because that's the card that's the creature that at least should attack. But now that in response to this death trigger, well, I guess they have only 2 mana left. So this is an activated ability, right? It doesn't return. Yeah, they have to use the 2 mana for it, so I guess I'll give them the chance to use 2 mana for it. But yeah, they would be at 4 life now. I'm very sad about this. Very sad. I mean, That's just insane. Well, at least they conceded, so they just had nothing there. So I won without the dragon, but hey, they did mulligan the 5. Well, didn't end up mattering because they conceded anyway. But pretty annoying, no matter what. Again, there's just nothing. If they had like a bomb enchantment or artifact, yeah, that would be a reason to sideboard that card in. And I don't need double study break. I guess I could sideboard in the study break if I really wanted to have more access to my lessons, but I don't think it's really important in this match. And all the cards in here, they are fine, yep. Oh, so how many starting hands of this kind I have gotten? Swamps, white cards. Pretty annoying. Gain a mulligan. At least this one is okay. And the Biblioplex Assistant is the least useful one out of those. Okay, well that Pilgrim basically buys me back the mulligan. Because I do need the mana here for the Archaic here. Okay, that gets flunked. Sure. Trip here. Yep. Introduction. So I will have the Wandering Archaic happening on turn 5. In the meanwhile, I can play at least the Eager first here. Okay, that's the best play. Top and bottom, alright. Interesting that they had no play. Okay, well. Alright. Let's not play the Wandering Archaic. It's so good for against the Rise of Extus too, but oh man. I guess I have to draw my Velomakus in this match then, in this game. Well, at least I wasn't gonna cast the Wandering Archaic on the next turn, because I didn't have the mana ready for that. Now I need my Velomakus and them not having removal for it. That's all I need. That gets exiled. Raising? I guess I can raise here. I will be scrying instead of drawing the card, because it's possible I can draw the Velomakus here. And scrying is almost the same. If it's a land, I don't need it anyway. That's a good one. That's a very good one. This one and... Yes, Baleful Mastery. What the? That's insane. I haven't even seen that card from them. Ah, that would have been so good. I would have attacked for 3. They put them to 12. Disgusting. Very disgusting. Now they have a 5/5 Trampler instead. I haven't even seen this card, and they had to have it in their hand now. I literally thought they are gonna have the, they could have the that thing that gives death touch and returns it, but it only works against death, not against exiling. So I thought I was in a very good spot here, but they had the. I was actually thinking I was in a good shape there. I'm not in a good shape anymore. I'm definitely not. What's the card? I can't take the... I mean, I can take like an introduction to annihilation or some stupid stuff like that. Just don't know if it makes a lot of sense. I guess I have to do it. Because I'm taking here now the million damage. That's so annoying. And just in case they had also removal for that thing. I'm taking 7 here. Oh, come on. Opponent. That's insane. I need my Velomacus now. Oh, that is not the card that's gonna win the game for me. I don't know if I can even win with the Velomacus anymore. I will be drawing a card though because I have the 7 mana. Because I'm going to 3 life now. Yeah, no, 4. Miscounted. Oh, what a combination of stuff. Okay, well this is... land is gonna give them a... it's not gonna work. Because this is gonna become a 4-4. If they have a spell... it's bad if they have a land, I just lose. Well, that was a pretty annoying one. I mean, if that would have resolved the Rise of Extas... Well, it did resolve, but if they didn't have the Darkness Snakeskin Whale, I think I was in a good shape. Okay. At least I have now a good hand with, you know, 7 card hand I can keep. And opponent did mulligan there. So I have 1 match loss now. So this, the next loss will end the event. I'm at 2 wins, so the next win would be sweet because that is the break-even point. I would be rewarded with 2 draft tokens if I manage to win this match. With 2 draft tokens, I get, you know, because I paid 3,000 gems for this event, that's gonna give me all I need back. But let's play this game before I think any of that kind. So definitely environmental sciences is here the choice because I don't have more than 1 land in the hand. Okay, guiding voice is annoying. Yeah, does the opponent have to have such an aggressive start? They're on the play too. They did mulligan though, which means that well, okay. With the fanatic, it's actually a bit better. I can start gaining life too. But this was the perfect blocker on this Eager first year, but nope, they had the pump effect. But yeah, this Guiding Voice is a very good card in this format. The difference that the 1/+1/+1 counter makes, even in the later stages in the game, it can be just a big, very, very significant difference. And you always get to learn too, so you get some other card. Of course, putting a 1 counter... Okay, the opponent really... Well, I guess if they remove their lifelinker, it's not such a big deal. They use their entire turn for that. So now I'm going to just play the sciences, get a swamp. But yeah, the it's not worth a card to... Not worth a card to just... add a counter on a creature. But it's definitely... very good when you get another card, a lesson from your toolbox, in addition to growing one of your guys. So they will have now 2 cards I don't know about. And I guess every Magecraft trigger will make this thing a target for my defender campus. So I take the 4 damage now, and then maybe... Well, I guess I can just, you know, draw a land here. That's an annoying one too. I got my own Guiding Voice though. Okay, what does that mean? I don't have an environmental sciences anymore. Who gets the counter? I'm going to take that Inkling Summoning. It will block the Silverquill Pledge Mage. That's correct. And now I can do it. can do it like this. This gets the counter so it can block the Eagle first here. I will take the Inkling here, which I'm going to cast. And then I'm going to attack with my own Eagle first here. And if they trade, that's fine too. If they don't trade, they take 4 damage and I have blockers for both of these things. And I have a lot of cards in my hand. They have 2 cards I don't know about it. They do have a Scry Land though, improving their draws. So what you got? Only attacking with the Eager first here. They don't want to trade with the 2-1. With their Pledge Mage. Another Pledge Mage, that's fine. Okay, Killian, I actually haven't seen this card a lot. Now this is great. I can play this and then the Defender Campus will also be a 2-mana spell if they have a Magecraft trigger. But do they have a Magecraft trigger? I could play the Eager first here too, but I might want to have the Beaming Defiance up as well. So maybe what I do here is just play the Killian and pass the turn. That seems to be the safest way. My hand is full of stuff, so I just should play here safely. I can't attack with the Eager first here. I'm not gonna attack with this because they could make these guys fly. That's not great. I could attack with the Professor, but then they have an attack with this now. I don't want to do that. I will just wait to draw, you know, maybe a more land so I can start pressuring them more. But I can attack with Killian here. Because I would trade with the Pledge Mage, because they have to block it with 2 things. And I think trading Killian with the Pledge Mage is fine. They seem to have a card of some kind. No, they really had a card of some kind. So this thing resolves. This thing resolves. The triggers. Let's see what they do there. So that's a lifelinker. And that's gonna be a lifelinker too. Now, target creature gets +3/+3 and gains flying until end turn. And then they draw a card and lose a life. So I can just kill this thing with Defender Campus. And that's what I'm going to do. Because it costs 2 less when I target their creature. No blocks. Defend the campus. Nice. That was actually nice. So, Killian attacking here. I guess I can attack with the Eagle first here. Do I want to? I mean, I guess I can attack with everyone. This could be really a spot where I can simply make a start raising them. With the Beaming Defiance, I can still cast something. Okay. I'm gonna attack with all. I hope that whatever they have in their hand isn't gonna be castable, because it seems like they're passing their priority all the time here. So, Beaming Defiance means that if they just block the Eager first here, I will use the Beaming Defiance on something. So that is either trade, or I can use the Beaming Defiance on the Eager first tier itself, so I just eat their Eager first tier. So this is what happens, so I'm going to do... Is this a lethal of some kind? 7... 9... No, it's not. So let's do this. Save this Eager first tier here. And now if they have a trigger for this, they can gain some life, but who cares? I will play this and I will have a lot of, you know, power. I have... You know, they have 3 power, I have 11 power here. I never even drew the lands for these things. That's actually quite funny. One of my lands has come from the environmental sciences. Otherwise, I have been drawing just spells. But it doesn't matter because my mana curve in this deck is quite low, excluding the few very expensive cards. But I have a lot of cards at 2 mana, as you can see. And the opponent is flooding out badly. That's just pretty crazy. Now, with the study break, I think I just... I'll do the study break. They're not gonna win here with the single card here. And yeah, I won with 4 lands here. Okay. So Silverquill Command. Well, that's another reason to be running the... discard spells, both of them. Again, do I want to play a study break number 2? I guess in some cases it might be good against like the Silverquill Pledge Mages when they give them flying or lifelink. I can actually kind of prevent the damage they would be dealing. But what card here is something I don't want? I don't think there is any card I don't want. That's fine. Let's play the deck as it is. I haven't seen my lore hold. Well, now I do, with a 1 land starting hand. Because this did win some games, but I have won a bunch of games without the dragon too, so the deck has something going on for it. But this is of course a mulligan. At least I get the planes back with the Pilgrim of the Ages. This is not a bad hand at all. I can have a 2-drop here, and then I can have a 3-drop that gets me a land and the Rise of Extus. Is going to be most likely a castable card. They have only 2 swamps here though. Seems like a removal spell. Flunk. But I will have, with the Pilgrim, I will get my 5th land. Okay, that's the 6th, so Rise of Extus will be cast. But that said, I do need to draw non-lands now for a couple of turns, because they are missing lands here, at least the white land. That means I need to be able to kind of capitalize. But I did draw a decent card here. That's gonna get me the Inkling most likely. Can't really see what else would it be. A creature to pressure them. And then I can use a study break. Get an expanded anatomy. Let's see if they get their white source. They kept the hand with only swamp. I do mulligan those myself. I do mulligan those hands, but they didn't. They had the flunk as the only castable spell. That was a pretty risky keep, if I may say so. They might just lose because of that. They need the planes like right now. Now they did get it. Might still be too late, but I have a Rise of Extus on their first creature. And I have 6 power here. They have 14 life. That's perfect. That's exactly what I wanted to tap out on a creature I can just exile. I don't care. Obviously, I don't care about losing the life. Because it has the ward ability. This goes away, yes, I'm sure, and this goes away. Take action, and I will get a... probably an expanded anatomy. Yep. That is actually meaning that I will have a lethal for the next turn. If they have no removal. But if they play creatures, I can just tap them. So they need removal specifically. But then if they use just mana for removal, they need also blockers, because I can't imagine them killing all of them unless they have an actual rat effect. Okay, that's fine. If they get like a inkling of their own, they will need to have a 1 mana interaction, which is possible. They could have a Lash of Malice. Okay, they get life from that thing. Okay, that's... So this would have been a win if they didn't get the 2 life here. I don't think I have a way to deal more damage, because let's see the lesson toolbox now. So there's a fractal unusable. These don't matter, reduced to this thing. I can deal 1 additional point, but that's not enough. I can deal. Not even sure if I had the mana for it. don't think I have. Because I have him. Just played 7 mana, so yeah, I can't cast the one damage dealing spell. So am I going to go for I kind of want to play the but I can play the remorse too, right? Oh, okay, yeah, let's first play the remorse then. This is gonna be so helpful. Double Rise of Extus. Wow, and they have a Silverquill Apprentice. But this is only a sorcery speed thing. So whichever I'm gonna pump here is gonna be exiled. So I'm not gonna... Yeah, they have to kill the flyer anyway. They have to kill the flyer. So yeah, let's make them use the Extus. I mean, let's not use... Let's make them, you know... Lose the Extus. So this is what happens. I'm gonna tap these guys. And I'm going to get myself... I guess a Pest Summoning. And then I'm going to most likely have a Expanded Anatomy on one of these guys, which they will... And they still have to exile there. Yeah, this is how it goes. Because now they will have to kill the flyer. Otherwise they will die. So they will tap out for that. And then they will have to... They will have to jump block the Professor of Symbology. Oh, I made a mistake. I would have won with the... Oh, I'm stupid. I should have gotten the one that deals one damage because I only... Oh, they have a mask of the exhibition. Okay, because the thing here is that if I took the red card, I only thought about it dealing damage to the player, but this thing has one toughness. Imagine if this was the thing that deals one damage. That would be just a straight up victory for me. Now with the mask of the exhibition, the opponent is actually in the game. Because they get enough blockers for all my stuff. Oh, I was so... That was such a mistake. I didn't think it. That was a... Because sadly, they get 3 blockers. They get 3 blockers for all my stuff. Oh man. I am very disgusted now. How many more lands I have? I have 8 here, so next turn I can just return this and play it. Might as well do this right now, but... they had... I mean, this in combination them having this Mythic Rare lesson. I'm not gonna say that anything else than I made a mistake here. And I draw a Humiliate right now then. Don't even know if the Humiliate does anything here. Counter on any of these guys just barely matters. Getting rid of the Silverquill Apprentice barely matters. I'll just do this. I need to draw something now. I can trade with the 4-4. No, with the 3-2. No, that's not gonna happen. Yep. I had to win if I thought more clearly. My mistake. And now they draw only spells. Oh, that would have been so good a little while ago. Oh man, why am I getting these draws one turn too late? I would have a victory if I had more creatures than they. But they don't know it. They don't know it. I guess I'll humiliate them, see what they have in their hand, and just land. Okay, so I'll get a counter here, which is kind of useless. Whatever. So I can only hope they attack with both flyers and have a second land in here, then I have a victory. But they're never gonna risk that, right? They're gonna attack with at most one flyer. And now they have a blocker. Now they basically they could attack with both. So okay, let's draw the Velomacus. They attack with no one because they don't want to risk. I know I could kill this, but it doesn't make any difference anymore. There's no point. I guess I can attack with the Pilgrim of the Ages because I'll get my final planes. I have one planes left in the deck. Oh, let's do it. Wow. Funny. That does eliminate the possibility of me drawing a planes anymore. That is funny. Okay, Willamacus, I need you. It's the worst to lose games where you make a mistake, and that wasn't even that hard of a puzzle to think. The only reason I did know I have it in my sideboard, but I only thought that is it enough to finish them off. But I knew that they will be at 2 life, so it's not enough. 1 damage is not enough. Oh come on, I'm actually drawing all my lands here now. And without having, you know, any of my three you know, Skylands. So this is literally, is this all my basics? I have one swamp left in the deck, and then the three Skylands, and that's it. This is 12, this is 13 lands. One swamp in the deck is the 14th land, and the remaining three are the Skylands. I don't have much time here, because the opponent is actually, this is Flyer 2, and it has Vigilance, it can attack. They can attack me. Yeah, this is insane. I'm dropping all these lands after I have so many outs in the, and yeah, that is excellent. Oh my god. Oh, this is so horrible. I guess they don't have a win quite yet, but I don't know. I'm gonna at least scry in the upkeep. Because I think I have mana to even cast it. Yeah, I have mana for my dragon even. Oh my goodness, at least I have one more game, but I was winning this game if I didn't make a mistake, and then I drew lands, which actually very low chances to draw lands. I have, in this deck, what I have remaining is 3 lands and 15 non-lands. I still drew lands, the swamp and the campus. I'm gonna be going to 3 life now. So the combination of me making a mistake and having this kind of flood here, versus them having, you know, spells. This is super annoying. Yep, that's I can't believe it. Wow. So one of the three lands was still on top of the deck. Now there are only 2 lands in the 17 lands that are on the top of the deck. So it's 15 out of 17 to draw a non-land. And that's not gonna do it. Yeah, I could attack with the one, I don't know. Let's see what they do. I mean, they have to play around some stuff too. I could have like removal, but yeah, they can eliminate that. Who are they gonna boost here? Yeah, the combination of my mistake into. Yeah, okay, I'm losing now. I can save this, but they just fly enough. I'm disgusted. But yeah, first of all, that was my match to win right there. I could have gotten my second game win in this match, but I made a mistake. But then again, they had this extremely amazing exhibition, because otherwise they were going to lose to me having more creatures than they have. But they had a card, a lesson that keeps them with one card, 3 creatures. Making me unable to win with my pest tokens and the other stuff I had in here. And then I continued to basically draw all my lands while they drew just spells. They just were able to have a wider board than I. But even though that happened, it was all preventable by me choosing this thing from the lesson instead of the pest summoning. I would have had a win in that case. So it's me who is there to blame. And now I just have to focus on the remaining match because I can still win the match. And if I lose the match, that's just, you know, sometimes you make mistakes and lose because of that. It's pretty normal in Magic. Yeah, but I don't think there's just nothing to sideboard in here, so let's just try to not make any mistakes in further games. Yeah, I do need a land, but I have the Velomacus here at least, so please one more land or a 2-drop so that I can use the Guiding Voice to get an Environmental Sciences. Okay, that is fantastic. Now I'm happy about this this situation because I can play the Pilgrim for the 4th land. They have a good start too, but all I need is to find... I have a very nice 5-6-7 here actually. I do need another swamp, but I can get it with the Environmental Sciences. So I do like the chances here. The Velomacus can be very good now. Yeah, I'll just trade here, why not? They get the flyer here. Okay, that's actually... I was lucky. I know I could have you know, gambled a bit and not trade here. Because I need to play the Guiding Voice. But I drew the creature anyway, so... So I guess I got rewarded there. That is annoying, but Archivist blocks flyers. And that thing also does stuff. But I don't wanna miss my land drops. So I'll just do this and I have the Beaming Defiance up. And I can play on the next turn with the Bloom Pledge Mage. I'm taking 6 per turn in the air right now. I might even get the Environmental Sciences back at some point, but we'll see. Okay, Sealed Mage. Okay, they have a Flying Clock now. They have 7 in the air. That is a lot worse. So they can have... I know they have the Exile thing. But is there something I can help? Can I help there? I can play a Biblioplex Assistant. Or I can play the Cogwork Archivist. There's no reason to play the Witherbloom Pledge Mage. They had to have the 3-3 flyer there too. So now this is tough. If I play the Assistant, I can have the Beaming Defiance up. So I can block with the Laureate, for example. I'm not even sure if I want to have the Environmental Sciences here on top of my deck. Any land, well, unless it's one of the tapped lands I still have in my deck, is gonna give me the Velomacus. But if they have the Rise of Extus, I do want them to use it before the Velomacus. But I'm taking here 7 damage. It's a lot of damage here. I could take the Witherbloom Pledge Mage, and if they have a land rise, they could exile that, and then my better stuff that can actually block these things would survive. But if they don't have removal, of course they can have more than Rise of Extus here. I really wish I had their discard spell, that would be so great here now. Assistant can block and leaves me this thing up. I know this can draw me at least a land. I guess next turn I can play this and the Pledge Mage. Maybe I don't just... Oh, this is so tough. Okay, let's do this. I hate to do this, but because they can easily remove it, but... I guess I hope I draw an untapped land and play the Velomacus. and that they don't have more removal spells. If they remove the Archivist. Of course, if they don't remove it, if they don't attack at all, that would be perfect. That would be perfect for me, but I think the chances that they have something are quite large. Okay, that's... Is this opponent also playing... Okay, yes it is. I'm not gonna block that one. But it's weird that they play this. I mean, this is so risky. Imagine if I draw my removal spells. Agonizing Remorse is there. Okay, these things are getting very intense now. I guess it's pretty easy now, Agonizing Remorse with the Beaming Defiance that can block the Sealed Mage. I could assist them too, but I need to have the Remorse here. They didn't even have a land drop, they could still have a Rise of Extus in there. Now they have it. Okay, but I mean this does mean that my Beaming Defiance will be able to deal with the situation here. Don't have any other drops. Yep, that is. Now am I gonna attack with this guy? Because they can attack with everyone. I'm gonna skip that action. I mean they need a trigger for this thing. Otherwise I can't block with the Eager First Year. But they can just attack with everyone too. This is pretty intense. If I draw the stuff for the Velomachus, now I know they don't have removal for it unless they drew it. And when the Sealed Mage dies, they get to add a counter somewhere else because of the Sadewing Laureate. That's just something I can't prevent. So it doesn't seem like they would have a Magecraft trigger to make this thing fly. They have a tough decision to make there. Yeah, they didn't attack with anyone. Wow, look at this opponent. Well, at least I can play my assistant. Pretty interesting. They don't know anything about my hand and they chose not to attack even with the 5-5, which has a free attack. Okay, that's fair. I can make some... do I need to put something here? I guess, yeah. I don't want them to get back the Professor of Symbology, which they can then... which they can then use to find the mascot exhibition. Humiliate? Well, that's good. But, I still need the assistant. And it's time for me to actually get the environmental sciences. So it doesn't seem like I'm gonna get the land otherwise, so let's do that. It also gains me 2 life, which is nice. So, yep. Humiliate would be good, but I obviously need the Beaming Defiance here. That's fine. Very exciting. It would be more exciting if I didn't know that I would have already won the match by playing correctly, but... I have to just forget that situation. Okay, they have drawn good cards, but something that I can just... I mean, how good can be a Cogwork Archivist? It can be very good. I'll just make this go away. So, Humiliate gives me a counter on something. I can't play the Pledge Mage because I need the Beaming Defiance up. Might as well have them. Not gonna get the planes if I can at some point, you know, use the pilgrim. I want to leave the planes in my deck. Guess I just don't need the mountain. So let's take the swamp. And then what I can do is play the Humiliate, see what they have in their hand. It could be like another Rise of Extus if they have more than one of those. Yeah, that seems to be the case. And I will give the counter to... Okay, eliminate. Well, that's a good thing to get rid of. It could be the assistant, then it can block the shield mage. It's a bit fishy that the opponent realizes that. Why didn't I give the counter to the Cockwork Archivist? because it could block the 5/5 then. What trait they are gonna offer? I could attack with the Eager First here. They can block with flyers and make the lore aid do some stuff. No, they have ground guys. I just need to have all my guys as, you know, doing blocking duty. I don't actually want to have the, you know, play the Velomachus so that I don't have the Beaming Defiance up. Okay, they just keep on roaming. They have 5 lands and... Wait a minute, how many cards in their deck they have? How can they have... Well, I guess because I put back cards to the bottom of their deck. Yeah, that's the reason. I have put cards to the bottom of their deck. That's why they have still 26 here. Is there a way for them to return instant and sorceries back to their hand? With these colors? I don't think so. So, I guess I'm gonna wait until I have 8-9 lands and then I play them Velomachus, because now I can just play them with the Bloom Pledge Mates. Now they do have, you know, blocks for this Velomachus, that's one thing too. I kinda need an answer for that. Because they will just block it with multiple things. The Velomachus isn't even that great. It can give me one free cast of a spell though. But there is the land. I have the required amount here. But I guess it is just going to be an attack with the Pledge Mage right now. Because I don't want to just attack once with the Velomachus. So let's... Okay, they actually take just that much damage there. That's good. I can return the Pilgrim here. So they're playing around Pilgrim here. They're playing around Beam Defiance for sure. Because that's the only thing, they haven't attacked with the 5/5 shield mage. It's kind of pointless to have it when they don't use it. But I mean, I don't mind. I just got 5 damage there. Okay, study break. Now things start to be a lot more interesting now. Study breaking this is just extremely expensive though. But let's just first attack here and see what they do. They can't take this many times. But they are still doing it. Interesting. Very interesting. I don't know what's their game plan here. Maybe they have a discard spell, they were waiting for that. Yeah, I won't be paying like 6 life to tap these things. That's just not going to happen. I can get with the Beaming Defiance though, way to exile these things. That might be worth using 3 life, because the Pledge Mage here actually gains me back. Life back here. Did I have at some point, I don't think I had the Cambus Scry mana up here, so... because I used the Pilgrim ability on the previous turn, but now I can actually, even if I use the Study Break on that turn, I can actually use the Scry here. Silverquill Command. So that will trigger. There's nothing much I can do about that. That will trigger. They choose probably flying or lifelink. Could be either. Well, it's probably flying because the Pilgrim can just block them. Yeah, well, it was a lifelink. How do they choose here? So both of these have lifelink. And this gets flying and I will sacrifice a creature. Okay. Well, I'm gonna study break here for sure. So what is the creature I'm gonna sacrifice? Probably the Pilgrim has to be it, right? I mean, I don't want to lose the pledge mage. So let's that resolve. I'm not going to die because I have the study break. Pretty sure about that. So now I will study break. I will study break the 6-5 of course, and probably just the 3-1. Isn't that the case? I'm not gonna lose here, right? I'm not gonna lose here. Getting some life here too. And this is going to be a, I don't know, I don't have that much. Well, I have a lot of timeouts, but I have 6 minutes and something time here. It does feel like it could be a number of things. It could be the start from scratch too, but it could be expanded anatomy. It's quite good also. But this can just kill one of the three ones, so let's take that. Okay. And let them attack. Let them attack. If they attack with like all, I don't think I'm dying. And then they would die to the counter attack. So finally, now they might have a 2 mana instant. I don't think they have a 2 mana instant to deal with the Beaming Defiance stuff here. Okay, so they go for it. Now I could just, also if I survive here, I would win on the next turn, right? Well, they get 3 life here though. What a match. And I already would have won the match here if I did get this in the previous game. Well, I have said that like a million times. You know that. But hey, if I win here, that's okay. Now they left this to block. So let's pass to blockers. And that's gonna be the case. And this is gonna be the case, right? And I think this is gonna be the case. Or do I even need to block there? Now I have 2 timeouts. So this means the assistant, I'm gonna take here 7 damage. They get some counters here though. They can give this guy counters so that he doesn't die to the start from scratch. But I have the Velomacus here coming up. But if I kill this thing, it's a bit safer, but because this will survive, this will die. They will get 2 counters on somewhere. I don't know where it is because of the lore rate. It's a bit safer to kill the pledge mage though. But that's 7. I will be at 6. And then I attack with all. They will be at 11. With that. I mean, I think I win here if I... Yeah, I'm not sure. It might be a mistake here, but I think the Eager First here attacking next turn will be better. Because I have the Hasty Attacker here too. Oh, it's a non-token actually, but no, it doesn't matter. They lost two tokens here. And it's not a non-token. A creature with flying. Resolve. Well, they are not going to even kill that thing. Am I winning here now? Did I count wrong? So they block the 5-5 and they take 12 here if they have nothing. Yeah, I mean, of course I'm gonna attack with all here. Oh, they have something. Oh, they have their own study break. Alright, well, GG then. No, they didn't have a study break. So they have something. But let's just go, whatever. Eliminate this guy. Okay, is this gonna be enough? It is. Oh man, what a match. If they could have had a study break there. Okay, well, I mean, I won this in game 2 with correct play, so I guess I wanted to play one additional game against that opponent. But now I got to the sweet spot of getting 2 draft tokens back, so anything else will be just bonus. Okay, it's a playable hand, although third land is really needed here. But I have like 3 spells I can cast here. Oh, and that's even a more of... if they have a Lash of Malice, yeah, oh man. A smart guy would have maybe played the Beaker first here, because this is a possible thing they could have with that mana, so... Pretty annoying, actually. Well, at least I got the third land, so there is that. But yeah, I mean, it's just so good when they don't have it. So because you start getting this, you know, lifelink attacking here with many, so I don't know actually. They chose to not block, so they want to raise here. That's only 1 damage they dealt to me, and they are gonna take 2 here. Unless they have another Lash of Malice. I will play my creatures, because these will be... Because next turn I can cast the Agonizing Remorse, and then it will be, you know, this will be 3-2. I guess one of these dies now. Okay, none of them died. Why would this attack? Why would they attack with this? Trade 1 damage to 2 damage. Maybe they are very aggressive. Okay, humiliate. So maybe first I will Agonizing Remorse. And then I can humiliate. Because if I do it the other way around, they might still, you know, have somehow. Well, I don't know. This just because I know I'm going to cast them both. I'd rather get the information and then I have. Well, I mean, you don't target the creature that gets the counter, so you will. I don't think it matters too much in here in the end. But whatever. I will get rid of 2 of their instant speed interaction because they of course have something. They just played nothing on turn 3, nothing on turn 4. They're gonna have something there for sure. And they have not a lot. Plum the Forbidden, Tent the Pests. Well, nothing amazing here. So I will... this does nothing unless they... I will be, of course, getting rid of the Pledge Mates, but maybe I will also get rid of the Plum the Forbidden. Yep. So that goes away. And they don't get to draw cards, and then this will happen and will take away the Pledge Mates. And then this Pilgrim will get a counter, which will be relevant against the 1-3. Guess I didn't need to play the land right now, but now they know I have red here, so what? But I don't have to. I can now, you know, this is faster way to do this turn. So Tentapest is not great when they have only 1 power creature, and they just took 11 here. And I know they have 2 lands here in the... The Drew of Leech Fanatic, which is not that amazing. Do I want to leave a blocker here? Yeah, I do. Just attack with the Pilgrim here. Because if I attack with both of these, they can block one of them and then they can find, you know, get 3 more life. 2 more life, I mean. Well, let's do this attack. I don't mind with the trade. The Fanatic trade is obviously fine. And the Campus wasn't bad. I get to scry on this turn, well, on their turn. Well, they just chose that, which is completely fine for me too. But I get to scry and I also have the 6th land happening. So this, yeah, they get one pest when I Rise of Extus this. Well, I'm not saying I'm going to Rise of Extus this, but it is a possible scenario here. Okay, Guiding Voice. Well, that is something I'm going to play. They would have to have an instant speed interaction here. So if they do, then they do. And I will get an Inkling Summoning here for sure, if this resolves. And now they're gonna have to... Well, they're gonna have to block here. They can do it, they can block with this thing and then use the Tenta Pests. So they will block this and get a, replace this with the token, but they will still take 4 damage here. It's still a 2-for-1 for me. So if they have a big blocker, I can exile it. If they have small blockers, they can deal with. Yeah, okay, so now I have a potential victory. But with the Combat Professor, I have it too, without even risk, without even using the Rise of Extus here, so... I kind of forgot to have this in my deck. I haven't seen it a lot. I definitely haven't. Alright, so that was a victory. And again, nothing to sideboard here. Just keep in mind, they have a Lash of Malice. They have a Tenta Pests. Mage Hunter's Onslaught, Plum the Forbidden. Alright, so no, don't need this. Hand isn't great, but this can kill the... No, green deck has... big things, and I saw them with the Bloom Pledge Mage. It has all the colors except for double black. I think I'll keep it, and I hope to draw my, one of my two drops or early plays, because I have a bunch of those. But I know this can also backfire badly. If my first play in this game is a Biplex Assistant on turn 4, that's not impressive. Okay, I drew the double Swamp here. I know now I have the double caster available, but I don't need more lands in this hand. Thank you. Let's draw a spell. Come on, that was three swamps. But opponent doesn't do anything either, so I guess I can play a 4-mana 2-1 flyer if that's what's required. Or they have one. Whatever. Yeah, three swamps in this hand. Not great. Okay, I guess I'll kill that thing. And now I draw the spell. Alright, so I'm going to choose now a bit differently, actually. I'm going to make this a 3-3. Block that thing, get some kind of a lesson here. Probably the Inkling to block their flyer. Would they choose not to? Maybe they want to leave it as a blocker. I mean, that does mean they have no other blocker for the Leech Fanatic. If they think that they don't want to deal 6 to me in case I don't block, and I will start gaining 3 life. But they have the Pledge Mage here still, so I'm not sure. Well, I could double spell. But the Pledge Mage is gonna deal 5 damage to me anyway. So I think I'll just do this. And am I gonna attack? If they block, that's great for me. If they don't block, they will deal 7. But I will be at 19. Yeah, I can do it. Hopefully they block. But if they don't, I will drop to a 12. I can live with that. basically the Professor of Summoning is dealing like one damage to me because I just drew. Well, actually it's two because this pest wouldn't have attacked. But at least I got to deal some damage to them too. Of course, to win the game, I need to also deal damage to them. Okay, that's great. That's actually pretty nice. They might have some trick here, but I'll still can play my combat professor, and then I can have the arrogant poet. And if they have nothing, I get to gain 4 life here. Flunk in there. Well, they flunked my 2-drop and not the flyer. Do they have mage hunters for the combat professor? If they do, then I'm just dead, basically. Well, I'm not exactly dead. I can also always draw, for example, my dragon. I actually do have 7 lands, including the red source here, so... And they have a mortality spirit. Well, that was a pretty... I mean, if they had this sequence of cards, that's gonna be bad for me. So I'm going to block the 1-1 here, because that's really the best I can do with the arrogant poet. Well, that's too late. That is rough. So I can get back a Guiding Voice defense to campus. I can play the assistant. Oh, but this thing is lethal. I have to jump it. Now that's boring. Well, I mean, then I jump it. But is there a reason for me to return anything in that case? Because I will have to trade and jump. I have no creatures left. So if I draw one of these, I am going to just die. So I have to draw the Velomacus. Okay. I have to draw the Velomacus. Decline this. But they had to have the removal. Flunk and the Mortality Spear. I mean, that's 2 excellent cards. They got exactly rid of my things that were keeping me alive. The Lifelinker and the Flying Blocker here that could block the 2-1 here. So now I only have to block the Zoomans here. So because I need the Dragon specifically, I will just trade with the thing that can drain life instead of the Flyer here. Now let's see them play a creature and me having no dragons. Okay, Drudge, sure. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Well, pretty much the same stuff going on here. Okay. This is nice. Turn 2 fanatic into humiliate. Unless they, of course, they can have the Lash of Malice. But if they don't, they play a swamp. Well, I mean, what else can I do here? Play a study break, get the inkling. Yeah. Yep, Lash of Malice. That is so nice. That is so nice to have it on turn 1. Okay, that's okay. I can get this guy to grow then. Doesn't have a lifelink. Do they have multiple of those? Oh yeah. They are very good against my deck, because my deck has a lot of these 2/2s. And they have these. And now they can just... Yeah. Very annoying. And then this happens. Oh man. I don't want to humiliate when I don't get the counter. And I need my... I guess I'm gonna just take an environmental sciences here. But man, this double last start is... not nice. So they have a trick here. Are they gonna counter this with like a 10 pests? Oh, they have a snakeskin whale. Sure. I can kill it with defensive campus now. Okay. If I ever draw the land. Well, now I need to do this because I have my mana used for so many turns here. they have the pledge mage too. That hand. Alas, snakeskin will all this cheap interaction to my stuff. They had the juke, they could sneak this in. And now they have two cards, I need to get rid of both of them. I have to get rid of the pledge mage. It's the worst one because I can defend the campus this thing. But at least they have only a 2-1 flyer. It's a small. Yeah, the clock is, you know. So quite. Well, I mean, they're gonna get me to 10 here, so it's not really ideal. But I hope they just draw lands here. Okay, land isn't bad because now I have the Rise of Extus here. So, yep, I will use the defend campus here. They had one snakeskin whale. I'm assuming they don't have another one. They could have the tent the pests though. Well, we'll see. They had nothing. So I have a combat professor. Exile effect on some of the guy. Okay, that can get exiled if I draw the land. I need the land right away. Damn it. Oh, that's so bad. Ugh. Because that is. They're gonna mage duel away the combat professor with this. They couldn't do it. No, they could do it even with the inkling. Okay, that's right. But they have a 4-power creature here. That's the problem. Yeah, it's not gonna work. Not going to work. Sadly. If I drew a land here, that would have actually been crazy good. Exile this thing and get something here. My own inkling, basically. Yep, that would have been a great draw. They could just go for it. Well, I mean, they can do it. I'm at 1 now. They had 2 efficient start here. Can't block them both. But I got to 3 match wins, and even though this last match was pretty frustrating, their start was just amazing. The Snakeskin Whale. They didn't even counter a removal spell, they countered my tap effect. So they get to deal 4 damage on the turn. And then I couldn't get my environmental sciences or whatever lesson I would have gotten there. So this start, double lash of malice on my 2/2s. That was too much for me to handle. But it's fine, it's fine. I mean, getting to 3 wins in this event is great. I got the draft token, so I got my entry fee back. And, you know, 6 packs, that's like a few gems and wild cards. But this was it for now. Next one will happen at some point too. I will be playing this. This event ends in like a couple of days, so I can still have opportunities to draft a few more of these. Claim the prize here. And thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye bye.